Anthony Nolan saves lives. Every 14 minutes, someone in the UK is diagnosed with a blood cancer. A stem cell transplant from a stranger, someone like you, can be their only hope. Because what makes you uniquely you could save someone's life. At Anthony Nolan, we match people who donate stem cells with those in need of a life-saving transplant. A good donor match is first about finding someone whose tissue type matches with the patient. But finding that perfect match is hard. Tissue types are incredibly varied between people. Remember the uniquely you bit? Which is why we need more people like you to join the stem cell register. Your stem cells hold limitless potential. By donating your cells, you have the power to give someone with blood cancer or a blood disorder a second chance at life. So about donating, we need you. You're unique. And that means you might be the answer to saving someone's life. When you come up as a life-saving match, we'll contact you and ask for some initial blood samples to confirm that you're a match. There are two different methods of donation. Nearly 90% of donations are done via your bloodstream through peripheral blood stem cell, PBSC, donation. You'll have a 4-day course of injections that stimulate your body to produce stem cells. You'll probably feel a little tired and achy throughout this process. This is completely normal, but passes quickly. When it comes to your donation day, you'll travel to one of our collection centres. At the centre, you're connected to a machine which takes blood from one arm, filters out the stem cells, and returns your blood to the other arm. This process takes 4 to 5 hours. If there are enough stem cells, they usually are, you're done. If not, you'll need another set of injections and return the next day for another session. After your big day, or days, you'll probably feel tired and might experience some flu-like symptoms. These always pass after a few days. Get plenty of well-deserved rest and you'll soon feel fine. 10% of people donate via bone marrow. At the time of signing up, you must be okay with either method of donation. To donate in this way, you'll be given a general anaesthetic so you won't feel a thing. During a short procedure, about 30 minutes, bone marrow is taken from your pelvis using a needle and a syringe. And don't worry, donors tell us that the pain after is only as bad as after a heavy gym session. For the few days afterwards, you'll probably feel some discomfort where the needles were inserted, as well as general tiredness. Take some paracetamol and get some well-deserved rest. All donations happen in the UK, and we pay for all your costs, including any travel and accommodation costs. You've just given someone the best chance of survival, all from joining the stem cell register. Thank you. One question that always comes up: why are people aged 16 to 30? Well, young people are most likely to be chosen to donate, as they're less likely to have long-term health problems, which might delay or prevent donation. Our research also shows us that donors aged 16 to 30 provide better outcomes for patients. That's why we focus our time, energy, and money on recruiting this specific group. How long will you stay on the register? So, young people are most likely to be called up to donate, but you'll stay on the register until you turn 61. And although the majority of people will never go on to donate, you could still be asked any time up until that age. Okay, what about costs? Costs you nothing at all. If you're a match and you come to one of our collection centres in London, Oxford, Sheffield or Manchester, we'll pay for your expenses, including travel, hotel, food and any loss of earnings. And the process itself, can you choose which way to donate? 9 in 10 people will donate through peripheral blood stem cell collection, also called PBSC. However, on some occasions, a patient will need stem cells extracted from bone marrow. When you join the register, you must be willing to donate in both ways. And what if you're already on another register? You only need to join one stem cell register. There's no need to join ours as well. All potential donors in the UK are added to a single registry managed by Anthony Nolan. Joining more than one would create duplicates and waste valuable resources.
Hello, my name is Ethan, and I signed up to the Anthony Nolan Register back in 2015. It had only been 3 years that I'd been on the register, and I remember ringing all my family and telling them that I was a match, and I don't think they could believe it either. Sitting down with someone from Anthony Nolan and having them explain step by step what's going to happen and everything like that, it made the whole process so much simpler. 2 years after, can share your information with the person you donated to. And then one day I was in town and looked down and I had a Facebook message from someone, and it happened to be the girl I donated to. Amazingly, I have been able to meet her, and it kind of brought everything into perspective and made me realize why I signed up and why other people should sign up, because seeing her well and with her family and traveling and at uni and doing all these things made everything worth it. And I was in hospital for 2-3 days max, and she had gone through so much. So yeah, like I said, signing up was one of the best things I've ever done. It's free, it's quick, it's easy. You get sent the swab kit, you can do it at home, and then you just send it back, and it's that simple. It takes no time at all, and it can literally help save someone's life.